Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to talk about ViewModel in Android, and we are going to use this project. As shown, we have a role button, a number of roles, and dice 1 and dice 2. Pressing role button, each time we have dice 1 different value, and dice 2 different value, and increment number of roles as shown. We are going to create dice UI state data class. Inside it, we have any UI values that will be changed over time. Here we have dice 1 value, type integer, dice 2 value, type integer, and number of roles. And we have also a view model class, dice role view model, extension view model. We should add this line inside our gradle file and synchronize. Okay. And in our view model, we have a mutable state flow of type dice UI state. And we have a roll dice method for updating our values, dice 1 values and dice 2 and the number of rolls. And we should mention that here our data generated inside our view model as shown random values for dice 1 value and dice 2 value and increment number of rolls. At this point, we are going to explain view model in Android in details. So let us begin. Why should we implement the view model in our application? To answer this question, we first should talk about app architecture. The most common architecture principles are separation of concerns and driving UI from a model. Separation of concerns states that the app is divided into classes of functions, each with separate responsibilities. Driving UI from a model states that you should drive UI from a model. Models are components responsible for handling the data for an app. They are independent from the UI elements and app components, so they are unaffected by the app life cycle. As shown in our example, our view model responsible for handling data for UI components. First dice value and the second dice value and number of rolls using random functions and increment functions. As shown by pressing roll button, dice 1 value become 2 and dice 2 value become 4. Rotate our screen. The values unaffected by the recomposition of the UI. Recommended app architecture. Each app should have at least two layers. Data layer, a layer that stores, retrieves, and exposes the app data. And the UI layer, a layer that displays the app data on the screen. Let us talk about UI layer. The role of the UI layer is to display the application data on the screen. Whenever the data changes due to the user interactions, such as pressing a button, the UI should update to reflect the changes. The UI layer is made up of the following components: UI element components that render the data on the screen. And you built this element using Jetpack Compose functions. And state holders components that hold the data and expose it to the UI and handle the application logic. An example of state holders is a view model. As shown in this diagram, part of the UI generates an event and pass it up to the view model. And our view model passes down UI state and the UI display it. This is called a unidirection data flow pattern or UDF pattern. In our example, pressing roll button generates an event and passes it up to our view model by calling a roll dice function. In our view model, a roll dice function responsible for generates our data and update a UI state values using a mutable state flow, and our view model passes a UI state down to our UI using screen UI variable and collect our flow as collect as state and update our UI element images and number of rolls. The view model component holds and exposes the state the UI consumes. The UI state is application data transformed by a view model. View model lets your app follow the architecture principles of driving the UI from the model. View model stores the application related data that it is not destroyed when the activity is destroyed and recreated by Android framework. Unlike the activity instance, view model objects are not destroyed. When you instantiate a view model, you pass it an object that implements the view model store owner interface. This may be a navigation destination, navigation graph, activity fragment, or any other type that implements the interface. Your view model is then scoped to the life cycle of the view model store owner. It remains in memory until its view model store owner goes away permanently. View model scope. A view model scope is defined for each view model in your application. Any coroutine launched in this scope is automatically canceled if the view model is cleared. Coroutines are useful here when you have work that needs to be done only if the view model is active. View model in Jetpack combos. The most important thing to keep in mind when using view model with the combos is that you can't scope a view model to a composable. This is because a composable is not a view model store owner. To get benefits of view model in combos, use combos navigation or use view models in composable function as close as possible to the navigation destination. That is because you can scope a view model navigation destinations, navigation graphs, activities, and fragment. In our example, we instantiate a view model variable by a view model's functions and pass it to our composable function dice roll screen as a parameter. Here we scoped our view model to our main activity. When destroying our main activity, the view model destroyed also, and any coroutines run on it. Create view models with dependencies. When injecting view models using health as dependency injections and solutions, you don't have to define a view model factory manually. Health generates a factory that knows how to create all view models annotated with health view models for you at a compile time. Classes annotated with Android entry point can directly access the health generated factory when calling the regular view model APIs. Instantiate a view model. In an activity or a fragment, we can get a view model instance as normal using view model's Kotlin extension. For example, variable view model of type dice roll view model by view model. Okay. In combos, we can get view model instance using a view model extension as shown and pass it as a parameter dice roll view model of type dice roll view model equal view model with Jetpack
navigation library. When using navigation combos, always use a health view model composable function to obtain an instance of your annotated health view model. As shown in this example, if my screen is a destination in a navigation graph, we call a health view model to get an instance of my view model scoped to the destination as shown. Thanks for watching and please subscribe my channel.